Welcome to the Think Tank. That's right, no green screen, can't be fucked rendering. We are basically doing discussion about tattoos. And of course, tattoos is a very controversial topic, and it's sort of a taboo topic. But tattoos implemented in metal, that's what we're talking about today. And a lot of people, a lot of my fans probably do have banned tattoos, but there's also some negatives to have banned tattoos as well. And I'm going to give you some reasons on why you shouldn't get a tattoo and some reasons why you should get a tattoo. So I came up with this video because, as you know, a lot of people know that I work in retail, and I had a customer approach me, and I was serving this customer, and she saw a tattoo on my arm. And she said, "Oh, you shouldn't be revealing that tattoo in public. It's an absolutely disgrace. You should have it covered up. I'm going to report you to the manager." I was like, "Hang on. First of all, fuck you. Second of all, stick that breadstick up your ass and never come back. And third, who the fuck do you think you are telling me that I should be covering up my tattoos? It is not the 1980s, lady. It is 2020. 2020 may be the most crappiest year of all time, but you don't get to tell me, you do not get to tell me that I should cover up my tattoos." And a lot of people would probably have the same problem. The reason why I got tattoos, I don't know. I wanted tattoos to maybe feel a little bit better. Like, there's a sort of security when you get tattoos, in my opinion, that something you're going to keep forever. And especially when you decide to take that step and have a ban implemented onto your arm. I mean, it's just an absolutely fantastic fucking feeling. You know that you are dedicated to this ban. Now, I have 3 tattoos, and later on throughout this video, I will reveal finally my tattoos to you guys. First of all, we're playing devil's advocate, and the first reason why you shouldn't get a tattoo is because maybe the band you actually love now, maybe in the next few years, you will actually hate and move on to another band. Or maybe because their music style has changed. At 16 years old, you may love, say, My Chemical Romance. You get that tattoo at 16, and all of a sudden you listen to some absolutely amazing shit like, say, Mayhem. And then you decide to say, "Hang on, I love black metal, fuck this emo shit, but I got a My Chemical Romance tattoo on my arm. What is going on here? I can't get rid of it." That's probably why you shouldn't get a tattoo, is because you may regret it in the future. Maybe that's why. You could probably say the same thing as Bring Me the Horizon. You get a tattoo on Bring Me the Horizon, or you even get a tattoo of Opeth or something and don't like their new sound. Maybe you'll get picked on by your other peers. You maybe say, "I'm not a fan of their newer stuff. I'm a fan of their older stuff." The reason why you got this band tattoo was because you vibed with it. But now you don't vibe with it. Number 2 is maybe everyone's questioning, what does that tattoo mean? Why did you get that tattoo? Why in God's name did you get that tattoo? And that could be annoying as well. Don't mind me, I've had a few people ask me why I got this tattoo. How come you got this tattoo? Don't you realize what this symbol means? It's very satanic. I don't really give a fuck. But a lot of people would, absolutely sick and tired of explaining why you got this tattoo by so many people that you just met. Next thing is, this tattoo you're going to get is very popular, and everyone's got this tattoo. And it sort of links to my first tattoo that I got, except my tattoo is just a little bit different just because of the design. But a lot of people do have this tattoo. No doubt a lot of people have this tattoo. Certain popular band tattoos like Metallica, Slipknot, a lot of people have these tattoos, and maybe you have this tattoo to fit in, but then you may feel just slightly insecure because you look at other tattoos and say, "Oh wait, that tattoo is better than mine." Sometimes you feel that way. You're saying, "Oh, this tattoo is not that great. It's not that great at all." Next reason is rejection. Rejection, you may be rejected. Say if you're going for a job interview, so-called future manager looked at your arm and said, "Hang on, what is that? I can't hire you because you got that on your arm." You'd be pretty devastated and you'd feel pretty insecure. And finally is, you may become a walking advertisement. Like, I wear band t-shirts a lot. You may become a walking billboard advertising the bands that you love, which is okay in my opinion. Of course, you want something creative. You want something creative, something different. And a lot of people would say, "Hey, you like so many bands that you are just a walking advertisement." And of course, the last one is that tattoos are painful. Yeah, tattoos are pretty painful. If you haven't got one, you won't understand the pain, especially after you get that tattoo. So obviously the pain is the reason why you shouldn't get that tattoo. Okay, now we move on to the reasons why you should get a tattoo. First of all, if you love the fucking band and you think you're gonna stay with this band for a very long time, you should get this fucking tattoo. Get this fucking tattoo on your arm. Second of all, who gives a fuck what everyone thinks? Just get that tattoo. Because once you get that tattoo, you're gonna feel so damn good. Third is band logos aren't very expensive. If you want a band logo, you're gonna fork around $200, $300, which isn't very expensive. But if you want something like a band mascot such as Eddie or Iron Maiden, you're probably forking out about $500, $600. But damn, it's going to feel good. Going to feel good. And finally, you get compliments. You're going to get compliments. If you're wearing a tank top or you're just wearing a shirt showing your tattoo, you're going to get compliments saying, oh, nice tat, mate. Great. Who was your artist? And you could obviously be an advertisement and hand over clients to your tattoo artist. To be honest, tattoos are fantastic in my opinion. They really are. Because it's a secure blanket. The reason why a lot of people have tattoos is because they probably have an artistic mind, if you get what I mean. So having tattoos isn't a bad thing, of course. I would recommend you to get a tattoo. If you love a particular band, get a tattoo. Because I'm saying you won't regret it. But of course, there are the negatives and there are positives. And you've come to the end of the video, so I'm going to reveal to you my tattoo. So the first tattoo I got was about 2 years ago. Now, this was a couple months before I started this channel. The first tattoo I got was a generic tattoo, and it was Slipknot. So let me show you that. It's Slipknot. As you know, you got the Slipknot logo, and you sort of got the cracking, which I wanted to crack. It looked like a crackly skin, and I thought it was fucking awesome. It looked fucking awesome. It looked fucking awesome when it was done, and it wasn't as painful, and it's my first tattoo as well. But of course, the tattoo artist sort of messed up my tattoo, because as you can see, it is fading, and I have to get it retouched once lockdown is over. But throughout the years, it faded, and it faded, and it faded, and my other tattoo artist said, whoa, we got to get that retouch. Next time you come in, we got to get that retouch because the other fuckhead doesn't know how to tattoo properly. It's funny enough because he worked with this tattooist, and this tattooist turned his back on the other tattooist and opened his own shop just 2 blocks away from his shop. So yeah, I was really happy with this tattoo. It was all black when it was done, and it even had like blood stuff and everything. It was fucking awesome. So now, the next tattoo was I got last year in December. After discovering Dream Theater, and I became a huge Dream Theater fan, I got this tattoo. I got the Dream Theater Majesty logo, which is absolutely awesome. I love this tattoo. I think it's fantastic. And the reason why I got this tattoo is because I absolutely fucking love this band. Dream Theater has become one of my favorite bands of all time. And it's number one. Slipknot was number one once. And do I regret getting that Slipknot tattoo? No fucking way, because I absolutely love Slipknot. Do I regret getting that Dream Theater tattoo? No fucking way. Absolutely love these bands. I think they're fantastic. Nu metal. Prog metal. So damn good. So what's next? It is Behemoth. I don't know if you can see it, but I got the Behemoth logo a few weeks ago. This was after the first lockdown. I got a Behemoth tattoo, and this is the Behemoth logo. I believe it's the Red Phosphorus King or something. I didn't give a fuck about the meaning, but I thought it was a fucking cool symbol, so I got it. And it's a little bit different as well. It's a little bit different because he added color, and I wanted color, something to stand out. And you know what? I think it turned out really well. But my God, it fucking killed afterwards. It really did. All the pain. The pain was excruciating, especially after. But I loved it. Absolutely loved it. And this is why the reason why you should get a tattoo. Want something that when you wake up and you look at it, I'm very happy with this tattoo. I love this band so much. And I wouldn't get a Behemoth tattoo if I didn't love the band. So my next tattoos I want to get is I want to get an Ahab tattoo. Ahab Tattoo, the Funeral Doom metal band. I want to get Ahab Tattoo, and I want to get a Swallow the Sun and Opeth Tattoo. Watch this space, because you'll be seeing more tattoos on me very soon. Probably after lockdown, I'll get another tattoo. Of course, we're going back to 6 weeks lockdown again in Victoria. But it is what it is. I hope you did enjoy this Think Tank episode. Comment below if you got tattoos. Comment below what type of tattoos you got. And I will see you in the next one.